Hey everyone, and thanks for joining us today. Imagine this, you just developed your new application and you want to ensure that the users can sign into Microsoft Entra External ID. My name is Chad Hasbro.
And I'm Yolo Ovitz. We are product managers with the Micro Identity Product Group. And we are here to guide you through this process. In this video, we'll show you how to enhance protection to your application using Microsoft Entra External ID. Our goal is to make sure that the right people and software components have access to your application, keeping everyone secure and efficient. The scopes in this video also apply to Microsoft Entra ID workforce tenant configuration.
Let's start off by diving into how to protect access to your application using Microsoft Entra External ID. Let's break it down into three key steps. First, think about the types of application you're using. Consider the programming languages, the platforms they run on, and where they're being hosted. This foundational step helps tailor the security measures to meet your specific needs. Next, you'll need to register the application in Microsoft Entra ID. By configuring the user flow, you can customize the sign-up and sign-in experience for your users. Plus, you can enhance the security with conditional access and multi-factor authentication. Finally, it's time to implement the authentication functionality within your application. This step ensures the applications are secure and the users have a seamless sign-in experience. Now, let's talk about how Entra External ID supports a wide range of applications, each with its own unique authorization flow. The good news, well, you don't need to have a deep dive into the technical details of OAuth 2 or OpenID Connect protocols. The Microsoft Authentication Library simplifies the sign-in process for you. However, it's still beneficial to have a basic understanding of the types of applications and their authentication flows. This knowledge ensures everything runs smoothly and securely. First off, let's talk about how web applications work. They run on web servers like Azure Web Apps, IIS, and Apache HTTP Server, and you'll access them through the web browser. When it comes to signing in, you'll be redirected back to the Entra External ID sign-in page. Once you successfully authenticate, you'll be sent back to the application with an authorization code. The app then exchanges the code for an access token. This whole process is known as the OAuth authorization code flow. Additionally, web applications can also use the SAML protocol. Next up, let's discuss single-page application, or SPAs. A single-page application loads just one web page from a web server and then updates the content dynamically using JavaScript. The front end is mainly written in JavaScript, often utilizing a framework like Angular, React, or Vue. When it comes to authentication, the flow is handled on the client side using JavaScript code. To sign in, the application typically uses a pop-up window, but it also can redirect to Microsoft Entra External ID. After successfully authenticating, users are returned to the application with an authorization code. The app on the client side then exchanges the code for an access token. This sign-in process is known as OAuth2 authorization code flow. Mobile and desktop apps are installed on a user's device. Sign-in is done in a pop-up system web browser or a web view. Upon successful authentication, the web browser will be closed and an authorization code returned to a pre-configured URL schema of the application. Then the app exchanges the authorization code for an access token. The sign-in flow is also an OAuth2 authorization code flow. For mobile and single-page apps, you can also utilize a native authentication which allows app developers to host a sign-up, sign-in, and password reset user interface elements in the application. Then, using native authentication APIs or SDK, to sign up or sign in users without any pop-up windows. We have a separate video that describes the native authentication flows in detail. Applications support input-constrained devices, or also known as browserless or headless devices. For these devices or apps, their screens or monitors are limited to text only. For example, smart TV, IoT device, robots, gaming consoles, printers, or even command lines. Due to the input constraints, the authentication would be done on another reach device, like say a user's mobile phone. This authentication flow is also known as OAuth2 device authorization flow. A background service or a script have long-running processes and operate without interaction of the user. This type of application is known as a daemon application. They are unique because users can't sign into these applications. Hence, authentication is done using the application's identity rather than user's identity. The authentication flow is OAuth client credential flow. Web APIs allow a software component to communicate and interact with each other over the internet. For example, a mobile application requests data from a database via a web API. Accessing a protected web API is done through OAuth2 bearer tokens, which can sometimes be called JOT authentication. Users don't sign in directly to the web API. Rather, the users sign into the application, then the application acquires an access token to all the other web APIs on behalf of the signed-in user. Daemon apps can also invoke a web API. Since there's no sign-in user's presence, they can call a web API with the application's identity, application permissions, and on behalf of the application itself. All right, y'all, let's switch some things up a little bit. Yo, what's the next step for protecting access to applications?
Great question, Chad. To enable syndication for your application, you need to register the application Microsoft Entra External ID tenant. It establishes a trust relationship between your application, web APIs, and Microsoft Entra External ID. Think of it as a one-stop shop, a central place to securely manage your applications and APIs. When registering a web, single page, or mobile applications, you should supply it with a redirect URI, which is a location where Microsoft Entra External ID redirects the user upon successful sign-in. For other non-interactive applications like web API or daemon apps, no need to provide the redirect URI. After you register your application in Microsoft Entra External ID tenant, it will provide you with your tenant ID, application ID that uniquely identifies your application. All interaction between any application and Microsoft Entra External ID include this ID. Applications that run on a server like web application, web API, or daemon applications that are capable of storing sensitive configuration details are classified as confidential clients. Therefore, they must authenticate themselves to Microsoft Entra External ID with client secret or certificate. Later, in your application configuration file, you will enter your tenant ID, application ID, and client secret or certificate key. In certain cases, application needs to call a secure web API. Take, for instance, a mobile or single-page application that needs to call one or more REST APIs. The configuration process begins with registering the mobile or single-page application as we just described. Additionally, the web APIs themselves must be registered. In the application registration of a web API, you will define and expose specific permissions, such as read and write items in a to-do list web service. Subsequently, assign these permissions to your web, single page, or mobile application, enabling it to access the web API on behalf of the user currently logged in. All kinds of applications, including daemon applications, can call the same web API, while interactive applications like web, single page, or mobile applications operate on behalf of a user, non-interactive applications like daemon apps function on their own behalf. In this diagram, the single page application invokes the web API to access the signed in user's data, like the user's profile. Daemon application on the other end runs in the background without any user context and invokes the exact same web API to access all users' data.
Thanks, y'all. Now that you've actually walked them through the registration experience for the tenant, the next step is going to be to create that user flow and link it to the application registration. The user flow itself defines and controls the user sign-in experience, like the authentication method or whether self-service sign-up has been enabled for that experience. User flows are widely used for external identities for both external tenants as well as workforce tenants in the B2B account settings. Each application can have just one user flow. That means that if you have several applications, you can use a single user flow for all of them. Or if you want different experience for each application, you can create multiple user flows. User flows are applicable for interactive applications. Therefore, you don't need to link your web API registration to an actual user flow.
Exactly, Chad. Now that we have covered the application integration with Microsoft Entra External ID, let's delve into the configuration of the application itself. Microsoft Syndication Library, or MSL in short, empowers developers to authenticate users within applications. Also, obtain security tokens for accessing protected web APIs. To enable syndication for your application, you need to register the application in Microsoft Entra External ID, as we discussed. Install the MSL library in your project, then configure the MSL library, such as the tenant ID, application ID, and application secret or certificate. For applications that invokes web APIs, you configure the web API URL and the permissions or scopes required to call the web API. Then add the UI elements like the sign-in and sign-out buttons or links, and handle the corresponding actions to initiate the sign-in and sign-out flow. Finally, protect access to certain pages or endpoints in your application. EMSA Library supports a range of application and syndication flows. It provides support for many platforms and programming languages such as .NET, JavaScript, Java, Python, Android, and iOS. It eliminates the need to learn and deal directly with the host to an OpenID Connect protocols. It simplifies the setup of your applications through configuration files. It can obtain security tokens on behalf of a user or an application, manage tokens cache, and ensure tokens renewal before expiration. Additionally, it helps you debug your application by providing actionable exceptions, data logging, and telemetry data.
Yo, developing EMSA Library is cool and all, but I've got some even better news for you. For our customers that have already taken advantage of hosting their web applications and web APIs on Azure App Web Services or Azure Functions, we made this just even easier with EasyAuth. The EasyAuth provides built-in authentication and authorization capabilities. Microsoft Power Pages also include integrated authentication features for your Power Pages application. Microsoft Entra External ID streamlines the process of integrating authentication and authorization into your application, utilizing the EMSA Library and EasyAuth to establish a robust authentication and authorization framework.
Okay, you made it to the end.
Now that you have a good grasp on how to integrate your application with Microsoft Entra External ID, it's time to take it to the next level. Perhaps try to make some enhancements to the user interface by customizing your both sign-in and sign-up flow, or adding a social identity provider such as Apple ID or Facebook, or even improving security with conditional access and multi-factor authentication. All these capabilities are at your fingertips, without any type of editing or modifications to your applications.
Thanks for watching. There will be more coming soon, so look out for the next one. Goodbye.